Defense Secretary Delfin Lorenzana, overall head of the government's task force against COVID-19, approves dividers between motorcycle drivers and backriding passengers. Motorcycle backriding is now allowed for couples, but safety dividers should be used to prevent the spread of COVID-19. But Senate President pro tempore Ralph Rector raises concern on the use of barriers. He says these may affect the safety of motorcycles. Social media users also cite sources saying installing a barrier could make the ride dangerous. Others say it doesn't make sense to put a barrier between couples since they live together anyway. Meantime, the health department fails to release the daily COVID-19 case bulletin for the first time on Sunday, July 12, due to significant volume of data gathered. On Monday, Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergara says there are 2,124 reported new cases for Sunday and 836 new cases for Monday, July 13. This brings the total number of cases in the country to 57,006. Monday also records the highest number of recoveries with 4,325 reported. Total recoveries are now at 20,371, while deaths are at 1,599. The health department says this is due to increased contact and mobility as quarantine restrictions were eased. Meantime, French epidemiologist Arnaud Fontanet says there is little chance of a 100% effective coronavirus vaccine by 2021. Fontanet says a vaccine takes several years to develop and adds, quote, "We have to live with this virus." Shares of media giant GMA Network jumped over 10% on Monday, July 13. The network gained almost 2.1 billion pesos in market capitalization. This comes as rival ABS-CBN was denied a new franchise by the House Committee on Legislative Franchises last Friday. Philippine Stock Exchange, meantime, suspends the trading of ABS-CBN shares. Under disclosure rules, ABS-CBN has to submit a detailed report on the impact of the non-renewal of its legislative franchise on the business, financial condition, and operations. The network shutdown cost ABS-CBN over 2 billion pesos in revenue losses, making it difficult for the company to service its debts. Over 11,000 workers are affected by the non-renewal, while advertising and production companies are indirectly hit. Meantime, Senator Ralph Recto says ABS-CBN does not deserve the death penalty. If it erred, penalize it. Because if corporate misdeed is punishable with extinction, no business will be left standing in this land. He notes the closure is a blow to democracy. He says a noisy press, all the more the sound from outlets which does not please our ears, is the soundtrack of democracy. Meantime, former ABS-CBN talents and now lawmakers House Deputy Speaker Lauren Legarda and Quezon City Representative Alfred Vargas explain why they did not take a stand on the network's franchise. Both cite conflict of interest in refusing to vote. Legarda, an ABS-CBN anchor for 12 years, was not present during Friday's hearing. Legarda said she was constrained to join the voting because she is author of the bill for the franchise renewal. Meanwhile, Vargas, a former actor in several ABS-CBN shows, was present during the hearing but inhibited from voting. He argues the House rules and the Code of Conduct for public officials impel him to inhibit from the proceedings. As public criticism mounts over the denial of ABS-CBN's franchise, House Speaker Alan Peter Cayetano says the House did Filipinos a favor by moving against one of the country's oligarchs. Cayetano says the denial of ABS-CBN's franchise follows the Duterte administration's promise to level the playing field. He also says the move has nothing to do with press freedom. In related news, actress Catherine Bernardo reiterates there's no abandoning her home network ABS-CBN. In an Instagram post, Catherine writes, "Allow us to give you the light when you need it the most. This does not end here. We will not leave you until you return. Be strong. We will get through this together." Catherine is among ABS-CBN employees, celebrities, and supporters who staged a noise barrage and motorcade over the weekend in protest of the non-renewal of its franchise. Other artists who participated in the noise barrage are actress Angel Locsin, Piolo Pascual, and Chong Di and Bianca Gonzalez. A huge majority of Filipinos agree Congress should renew ABS-CBN's franchise or be given a new franchise. pollster Social Weather Stations reveals on Saturday, July 11, the results of phone and computer-assisted interviews. A day before, on Friday, the House Panel on Legislative Franchises rejected ABS-CBN's application. The survey was conducted from July 3 to 6 as the House of Representatives held marathon hearings on the network's franchise application. At least 75 of the 1,555 Filipinos surveyed agreed Congress should renew or grant the new franchise to ABS-CBN so it can broadcast its programs again. Only 13% of those surveyed said ABS-CBN should not be given a new franchise, while 10% were still undecided. Majority of Filipinos, or 56%, also agreed denying the media giant a franchise was a major blow to press freedom. Some 27% of those surveyed disagreed. The chief editor of Malaysian news site Malaysia Kini was taken to court for alleged contempt on Monday, July 13. Editor-in-chief Stephen Gan was brought to court by the Attorney General over five readers' comments posted under an article in the website critical of the judiciary. The Attorney General says the comments eroded public confidence in the courts, and prosecutors argue Malaysia Kini facilitated publication of the remarks. Malaysia Kini's lawyer Malik Imtiaz tells the federal court Gan had nothing to do with publishing the comments. He also says the case could have a chilling effect on freedom of speech. Since a scandal-mired party seized power in Malaysia this year, criminal probes have been launched into journalists, activists, and opposition figures in what critics say is a sweeping effort to silence dissent. Malaysia Kini has long reported on corruption scandals linked to officials and is one of the country's leading current affairs websites. A video circulating online claims COVID-19 is not real and was planned by United States billionaire Bill Gates to push the use of vaccines and microchip implants. This claim is false. A certain Jesse Ugalde says in the video, Bill Gates already predicted the coronavirus pandemic in 2015. Ugalde also claims Gates is in charge of the World Health Organization and he wants everyone to be implanted with a microchip with the number 666. Ugalde also says COVID-19 really means certification of vaccination identity. He also questions why many people recover from the disease in spite of the absence of a vaccine. At least three Facebook pages reposted Ugalde's video. It has been shared more than 26,000 times as of writing, with over 923,000 views. But the original upload is no longer publicly available on Ugalde's profile. All these unproven conspiracy theories were already debunked by several fact-checking organizations. While there is an existing video of Gates talking about the high probability of a virus outbreak in a TED Talk in 2015, he never mentioned COVID-19 in his speech. Instead, he urged the people to prepare for the next possible epidemic. In June, Rappler debunked the claim saying Gates is developing COVID-19 vaccines with microchips. There are no official reports on studies being done on a COVID-19 vaccine that will inject people with a microchip. Gates also said he has never been involved in any sort of microchip-type thing. For the COVID-19 acronym, Reuters and Associated Press previously debunked the claim that it stands for Certification of Vaccination Identity. COVID-19 was named by the WHO back in February. CO stands for Corona, V for Virus, and D for Disease. As for recoveries without a vaccine, scientists explain humans fight off viruses that enter the body by producing antibodies.